Every day morning, I am going to the nearby park for jogging to burn some calories and the extra fat that I have saved during the lockdown. For that, I have to do very intense workouts and long jogging sessions. This is what happens every day with me. Due to intense workouts or jogging, I will get wet with my sweat and felt very uneasy. I desperately wanted a hot water bath after this. After completing the workout, I will leave for my home. Now, the most irritating part comes into the picture. I have to wait for at least 10 to 15 minutes for hot water.
In this waiting period, I will lose my mood and excitement to get a hot water bath. This is the most irritating problem I am facing now. So in this episode, we are going to see how to solve this. So without wasting time.
Hey Subbu, vasal geyser apatledra?
Yes, this one too. I always forgot to turn off the geyser after taking a bath. So let's see how we can solve these two problems. Before jumping into the episode, let me thank my favorite PCB manufacturer, PCBWay.com, for sponsoring this video.
PCBWay.com is one-stop solution for PCB prototyping, manufacturing and PCB assembly. Along with PCB prototype, PCBWay is also making assembly stencil within one-day production time. If you are using SMD components on your PCB, you should have this SMD stencil. You can get it at $15, which is the best price in the current industry. Select the shipment method and complete the order.
After my jogging sessions completed, simply I will take out my mobile and turn on the geyser before I started to home. So it will take around 10 to 12 minutes to reach home from the park by walking. The water gets hot by the time I reach home. Now I can enjoy the hot water bath without further waiting. Coming to the second problem, whenever I am turning on the geyser, I will also schedule a timer to turn off this after 20 to 25 minutes. So, by the time I complete my hot water bath, the geyser will be turned off automatically. So, I don't have to worry about turning off the geyser anymore. The hero behind this project is the Sono Power Module. The Sonoff can deliver up to 3500 watt power and it can withstand up to 15 amperes current, which is the perfect match for my geyser which needs only 2000 watts. So I have installed the Sonoff power as shown here. The mains power supply first enters Sonoff through this line and then it will go to the geyser based on our input from the mobile application. We can also turn on or off the geyser manually using this push button in case of no internet connectivity or no access to the mobile application. Here I have used Sonoff's remote control feature and timer feature to solve these two irritating problems. We can also monitor and record the power consumption of the geyser remotely as shown here. This is one of my favorite features of Sonoff Power. Of course, this is the main feature of Sonoff Power. There is another interesting feature called control sharing. Currently, the control of the device associates with me only. But if we are living with friends or family, every time they cannot ask me to turn on or off the device. So in this case, this feature will help us a lot. To activate this feature, all you have to do is entering your friend or family member's e-billing register email ID and sharing it. That's it. Now shared people can control the device and the particular activity will be updated in both mobile applications. Onboarding of SonoPower is similar to the Sono Basic module. If you wanted to know how to onboard it, you can follow the above video. So that's all about converting a conventional geyser to a smart geyser with the help of SonoPower device. I hope you have learned something new from this video. Try to convert your geyser to smart geyser using the SonoPower module. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section. Stay tuned to Electronics Innovation for more interesting projects. See you on the next interesting episode. Bye-bye.